wonderful intro, we do have our draft for Game 2 coming in here. You got to wonder whether the Shatter Demon is going to get banned. You got to wonder whether the Drow is going to get banned, because even though Fnatic was eventually successful, those two heroes did look at some point like they were going to win the game.
I don't think that DC needs to worry about their overall draft idea. Just don't over-adjust.
Yeah.
Like in their last pick.
I think it's less about the banning. It's just about getting the right strategy in this game. And Fnatic is going to be on the Dire side this time. Dire side plus first pick?
No.
Yep. Yes.
Oh, they got Dire side first pick?
Yep. Some teams are still favoring second pick,
I guess.
Well, I think it's...
Because if they take Shadow Demon, then...
I mean, they ban Nyx, it means...
There's a lot of focus, though, on like these cheese last picks, on your Huskars, on your Broods. There's a lot of players that think that there's so much cheese in the meta.
That's very obvious. They wanted Batrider, they banned the Nyx there. And then Fnatic's like, well, whatever, I'm just picking the Bat first. I'm not taking the other heroes. I'm not taking the SD, I'm not taking the Drow.
It's also possible that they're setting up for a Medusa.
Oh my goodness, the first Ricky game of Star Ladder.
Yep. Hasn't been banned this game, yeah. That was DC's second ban, right? Mm-hmm. First game?
Yes, it was banned. It's been banned in 19 out of 21 matches before this one. This is the first time it's been picked.
This hero is pretty good versus Batrider, because you can scout him doing his stacks and potentially kill him or steal the stacks.
Yep.
It's very, very important to have a hero that can
scout. It's also a very different approach to the game already. Just picking up the Ricky.
I mean, as long as... I actually like their early game approach where they have this hero running around. I think specifically against Fnatic, you want to have that hero to mess up a laning phase.
Yep.
Either Ogre, Ricky, Bounty.
I've seen other teams battle back against Ricky by getting their own Invis pest hero, like a Bounty Hunter.
Yeah, but
Bounty Hunter is a worse Ricky.
Yeah. I know, but like sometimes they're like, you know what, if you're going to annoy our mid laner in our laning phase, we're going to do the same thing to you.
You know what, Ricky and Bounty Hunter are better than Earth Spirit.
Yeah, you're right. That's why... Well,
They create natural pressure just by not being on the map. Yeah. Yeah. Whereas Earth Spirit actually has to do something.
So the Slark pick, very good versus the Bat. Very good early pick.
But why so early of a commitment to Slark?
Slark has been always like banned in second phase though in a lot of the games.
Yeah.
Especially against the way, DC. Also the way that they've already decided to play this draft, they want to play a much more chaotic game. It's not going to be like game one. So
this could be dangerous though. Like Slark is bad at being contested, and you have a Ricky, so Ricky's gonna roam around. You are gonna have only one support in the lane with the Slark. So right now, Fnatic is immediately taking their time whether they should maybe form a strong dual lane with the Batrider to contest the Slark, or put the Batrider elsewhere and just form another tri lane against the Slark.
You have plenty of defensive. I mean, the Shatter Demon is still on the table, right? I mean, you have plenty of defensive support still on the table to protect the Slark.
What happens if the Slark's just mid?
Slark sucks at mid.
Okay, there's your aggro dueling.
All right, we're in an ogre meta.
Right? Huh?
If it's gonna be bat mid, for example, and you just have one support mid, I don't think it's that bad for Slark.
I guess so. Yeah. If it's against a bat.
I think bat mid here would be really dicey. The thing is, right, we've talked about this so many times. It's like Batrider 101. Batrider needs a vision advantage to be good as a hero. And
no, but it's more about the fact that the other mid heroes I don't think really bully Slark as hard as like the previous metas. Like mid Mirana doesn't really hit that hard in the early game. Sure, you push the wave a tiny bit, but you just get a PMS in some region, and it's like whatever. Slark can lane against that. I don't really see like any super lane dominant mids that are just gonna completely destroy a Slark.
I'm sure there is.
Pugna.
I mean,
I read your mind every time you're thinking of something stupid.
I wasn't gonna say Pugna, but whatever.
You were gonna say Pugna.
No, I wasn't.
What were you gonna say?
Nothing.
You just weren't gonna say anything and just look at me. This is what I have to deal with.
For mid laners that are better than Slark, I don't know. What if you get like a Viper or a Razor?
Oh yeah, Of course you can
punish him in the lane. I'm just saying that the heroes that are commonly played mid don't necessarily beat him that hard.
Okay, yeah. I get it.
Do you?
Yes, I get it.
It's a shame Fnatic are on board with this ogre meta right now, though. I do agree he replaces wonderful roles like Earth Spirit and such of being an enforcer.
And just Bloodlust, you know.
I want them to like do the wings gaming and get like a Spirit Breaker. I think he's wonderful against both Ricky and Slark.
Yeah, he is.
But Ogre does a lot of the same things though.
Yeah.
Slark is weak against Breaker's like, cool. The heroes that can, you know, lock him down.
But if you pick Ogre and SP together, if you don't have a very fast-paced early game, you're gonna just do nothing with your supports.
That's a really
That's why I feel like they missed the.
I would have been surprised if they'd have let the Shadow Demon through to the second phase.
I would actually prefer to ban Disruptor though, like, instead of SD. Oh. Because Disruptor is better versus Slark compared to SD. SD doesn't do much against
Slark. But are you scared of the 5-man, right? If you're DC already? You don't want to have
with Ricky and Slark.
Team.
I guess so. I see Drow being overlooked, possibly. They might just go for another pushing hero.
I just think both teams have so much potential to just run at the Drow and totally screw her up all game long.
I don't think DC would go Drow.
No, I think, yeah, of the two, I think Fnatic's may be more likely to go Drow, but I think it's still very risky.
It's just having the Ricky already in the Slark as a deterrent to picking Drow, because you know if you don't like hit the timing properly, you can just lose the game.
Can they just get like a... Do they play Oracle? Do they just get an Oracle for now? Get a good anti-bat? And
I still
support.
Feel like if you pick Oracle, you run the risk of what Winter said, where you get aggro dual lanes, and
your
the dual lane could be very hard.
Yeah, your lane is very good versus one offlaner, but your lane is extremely weak if it's a dual lane or a tri lane, because those two heroes don't do anything against that.
So what do you get if you're the support if you're DC then?
I kind of like Dazzle.
Dazzle's fine, but overall, as long as Fnatic chooses to pressure the Slark, I think that is the most important thing. They need to go two heroes at least to the Slark's lane.
So I know, as I was saying, for DC, then you gotta get one support that can handle dual lane.
Even Dazzle Slark, Fnatic can still pressure the lane. I think Dazzle's probably like the strongest fit for the lane, or Witch Doctor, those two supports.
Yeah, Witch Doctor's okay, especially since they showed the Chen last game. So that kind of pre-counters that.
Chen is super good this game for Fnatic.
Okay. Again, look at the emphasis here that Digital Chaos is placing on vision. Like all three of these heroes provide vision.
They're gonna see the bat, like unless he's smoked, pretty much.
Unless he has Shadowblade. Huh.
That too. But that's like a fourth item.
I was gonna say.
I mean, I guess it could technically be a third item in this game since there's no Nyx, but. I think that maybe DC are going the route of it's a much greedier early game than I was expecting for a third pick. But at the same time, if you're trying to contest the Slark, then you're not contesting the Beastmaster.
Right.
And the Beastmaster gets a ton of farm and gets like one or two ganks off and you're probably back into the game.
There's the Oracle pick from the other side.
Yeah.
A much better pick for Fnatic than it would be for DC.
I agree.
Yep.
Good to bail out whoever gets locked down from the Beastmaster, obviously, and it has its fun little interactions with the help of that Fortune Zen.
But what do you do now? Because it's like, you can't pressure the Beastmaster and the Slark all the time.
That's the thing that it makes me really... It's hard to think about with both the Ogre and the Oracle, because the Oracle tends to be so passive early on and the Ogre really wants to be aggressive. I mean, I guess if it's dual lanes anyway, that doesn't matter as much. Wow.
Okay,
how terrible that lane is.
I am so confused right now.
Just run at that lane. Ogre and Batrider can just run over that lane.
So you just picked Darkseer right now?
The reason that they did that is because they were absolutely kicking themselves for not fourth picking Ancient Apparition against Secret last night.
But there was an Alchemist in that game.
No, there wasn't.
I thought game 3 there was an Alchemist.
There was an Alchemist, but they had to have their fourth pick first, and Secret picked their... They thought that they should have picked the AA fourth before the Alchemist picked
them. So that was just a draft oversight then. They were kicking themselves because Alk was in the pool.
Okay,
and they didn't pick
Timber into an AA.
Alright.
They might do Timber safe lane against Beast. I don't know, maybe. Timber versus Beast is pretty good, and then it's gonna allow your support to run around and just pressure the Slark.
And again, AA is also a hero that can take advantage of the vision provided by the other three to set up those out-of-nowhere ganks.
Yeah, but the early game is very weak now, and they can easily get abused by this. Oracle, Ogre are very, very strong in the laning phase. Timber is very good versus Beastmaster if they decide to put a 1v1 matchup in that lane. And it's very good versus Slark in team fights because you're all AoE damage. Slark is very weak versus that.
I actually have no idea how DC are going to win the laning phase.
DC might just get crushed.
I don't know what's going on anymore. Like, I was okay with her draft until the AA. Now I'm just like, what's happening?
No one understands Dota nowadays. It's so difficult to see what the teams are thinking.
We go back to Fnatic, though, and they have to get what looks like their potential...
Is there any way it's Resolution Beastmaster?
And he used to play that the time.
It's very unlikely here, I think.
But I'm just trying to think of ways that they could make their lanes better, but I'm just not seeing it. Like,
Beastmaster, Weehaw jumps on a Meepo here, and we all have a good time.
They are going to get dumpster.
Yeah, Meepo's banned, but...
They are going to get dumpster.
Oh, he was banned.
Look at Fnatic's lineup. It's like... They have everything. They have catch, they have teamfight, they have good lanes, they have AoE.
Look, I like Fnatic's draft better, but I don't think it's that lopsided.
Dude, their lanes are so bad.
They're gonna lose. The problem is the lanes are gonna get crushed, and then everything is gonna be very
difficult.
Unless
DC pull out the one clutch pick to mix everything up and be a game changer here and now. Misery, he's
Pugna.
Oh my god.
The Pugna comes out. Oh,
I'm going back to the hotel with that pick.
It's an Ursa. Okay. Game changer? Yes? No?
Yeah, it's mid Slark. All right, let's go, boys.
Yeah, I think this is
what resolution.
First of all, I'm not sure about that. This is a Wii Ursa.
No, because here, right? There's two things. They could be either anticipating that it's some. No, actually, it's definitely bad. It's bad offlane, right? For sure.
This is.
It's gonna be Ursa.
This is mid. This might be. They're gonna try and get the Ursa against either Timbersaw or Juggernaut in lane. Preferably the Timbersaw.
I mean, it doesn't matter. I think the other lanes are gonna still have a hard time.
But I thought the whole point of picking Ursa AA is to make sure that those heroes are together. Like, why do you pick them if they're not gonna lane? And I think that they want to put it in a safe lane, right?
What if AA is mid? AA just starts mid.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, you can do that too.
Why I think Ursa mid, and they'll basically run a dual lane mid.
Yeah, that's possible.
All right.
Still think they're gonna lose.
Final thoughts? Yeah, I have to favor Fnatic a little bit. I actually think this is closer than you guys are breaking it down, but I have to favor Fnatic a little bit here. With that, I think we're gonna hand it off to our casters one more. Time here is Kalagai and Winter.
Thank you so much, sir. I'm here on the casting couch with my good buddy Winter. We're getting ready to embark on a journey, Winter. Game number two, Fnatic versus Digital Chaos. It should be a good one here. You said through the draft you were pretty heavy in favor of Fnatic and felt like the DC laning phase will be a bit of a problem here. With the Ursa last pick, and it looks like how they're potentially laning it. We might be seeing an early omen as far as how the lane could go, but you're still feeling pretty strong that it's Fnatic's early game.
Ogre Batrider is just gonna run over and dumpster and destroy and send them out of the lane.
Alright, well.
This A and Slark is not gonna do anything against that dual lane.
We'll see. Maybe.
We don't have to see.
Digital
That's
Chaos
gonna happen.
On talent and skill alone will deter Fnatic and what you feel like will be just the casual result on paper.
They have to trust in this Ricky to do a lot in the other lanes. Because if they have Slark A against those two, I don't think that's much they can do. They just need to count on the Ricky winning the other lanes and compensating for the fact that they're just going to lose their safe lane.
We'll see if they can do it. As you can see, DC commit a very early, deep jungle ward here to kind of scout things out.
And just look at even Ohio's item. They are going to contest the lane. He has two fairy fires.
Yeah,
they
he's
know
ready
that,
for a fight.
Yeah, they know that this lane is just going to get really, really action-packed very early on.
Okay. Actually, speaking of an early action pack here, DC tempted to make a fight because Chilling Touch is one of the best level 1 items in the game, or level 1 skills in the game right now. So DC are not afraid to take a fight, but as I say that, Fnatic show themselves, show their front, and hey, we got a lot committed down here too.
Running in.
Four from Fnatic in the bottom lane. They pop an early dust. They're looking to go for an early kill on Misery here, and they get it done. DJ with the first blood. Fnatic, they strike first.
You say Chilling Touch, one of the best early game spells, but Ogre, one of the best level 1 heroes right there, charging up with no fear.
Yeah, no, there's no denying the fact that Ogre is very, very big. He's got an insane amount of armor, HP regen, and with any sort of base item, it'll
land. Okay, so they're gonna have three heroes down here to with this dual lane. So Ricky is not gonna pressure the other lanes, but look at Fnatic sending 3-4-3 down as well. So they're gonna be a tri-lane versus a tri-lane, which definitely I think Fnatic's tri-lane is much, much stronger than what DC have.
Yeah, this is going to be a nightmare for Resolution right now, trying to find CS on his Slark.
And if you look at the other matchup, it's gonna be Jug versus Ursa, which I think is Ursa favored.
I mean,
so this lane is good for DC and the other lane. But wait, okay, somebody died.
Good job, Winner. Pulling away from our try on try lane where you know action's gonna break out to force our camera operator, the wonderful Mont, to step away from the bottom lane and miss a kill. That was all you.
I promise not to mess around when you're playing with Draskal later.
Okay, we'll see about that.
And he's been upset that I'm messing around when he's playing the Smash game.
The Smash game. Mushi still gonna get harassed a bit, will be forced to eat up.
The other lane I was gonna go to was the safe lane of Fnatic, where they have Timber versus Beastmaster, which is super good for the Timber. So yeah. Both the solo lanes, Fnatic has one favorable lane and DC have one favorable lane, and the tri lane will be on Fnatic's favor.
So two out of three lanes.
Yeah,
that's good.
And Misery, like I mentioned, has to be roaming around trying to tip the balance in the other lanes, because there's not much you can do in tri-lane.
Yeah, he already got hit in the nose though at the start of the game. Fnatic not afraid to let them know, like, hey, we could have dust at any moment for you.
Okay, Beastmaster ditch the lane, Iron Talon jungle, and DJ is gonna look to run him down, steal his experience, try to kill him. Yep. Place a wall.
Oh, game. And 3-4-3. What are you doing here, huh, Moo? What are you doing here? You wanna jungle farm?
They
too
see
bad.
Two heroes here, so Slark is gonna be able to understand that he's allowed to farm in the lane now. I'm not sure about roaming two heroes. I was thinking that maybe Ogre should be the only one running around. Oh, Riha.
Okay. Could be a little bit of trouble. Fortune N leads into a near full duration Blade Fury, plus the club of DJ is going to be more than enough to get the kill.
That was rather strange though. They saw two of the supports in the jungle, but the Ursa is still playing very, very far forward.
He's like in the zone in the mid lane or something.
That was, in my opinion, a very big mistake there.
Or just not set of communication, maybe.
That was a big kill because they were moving two heroes, a big commitment on resources, and you give up a kill like this.
That makes the dual roam certainly worth it when you're able to follow up with a takedown in your mid laner.
And
so
they're gonna try to wait for another kill here.
They're like, is Moo coming back, huh? And when they see him not come back, they can figure he's up in
Riha.
The side camp.
They're gonna go on Riha. Riha is the big kill here if they can get him again.
Oh yeah. And here they go. They're going to leave with the Fortune's End. The Ignite's going to be there. Bushi with the Blade Fury. And we've seen this story once before, and it doesn't end well for DC. We will get taken down once again
bad.
In the mid lane.
That is bad news.
Fnatic are up and up right now. 4-0. You can start to see where we were all getting on Fnatic with their laning dominance here. As I do say that, though, I might have cursed Ohio as he will be taken down. It looks like DC recognized that no one's going to be in the bomb lane and they can make their
he
move
back.
He got
way too cocky there. He was very accustomed to having support earlier in the lane. Yep. As an off lane, sometimes you forget, oh, I had a support 2 minutes ago and I'm playing so aggressive. And then when they leave, I'm like, oh, crap, I forgot the support.
Yeah, but I would expect that from a pub, Winter. From a pubber.
We are all human.
These are pros. They should know when their team
humans.
Has left them. Yeah, okay.
Come on, cut them some break, Dakota. Cut them some slack, you know? They make mistakes like us. We're all normal human beings. Maybe less mistakes, but they still make mistakes.
Yeah.
You're not amused.
Everybody makes mistakes. I agree.
You're like, the pro players.
I may have said a certain player's name wrong all of one day of casting. People make mistakes. We're all human.
Soxa.
Yep. Soxa. Bottom lane. On
you
your
need
AA.
More, you need more practice, Dakota. Soxa.
Soxa. I say it like it's so awkward, I feel terrible, I know, I'm sorry. The Ancient Apparition player moves up, gets spotted out by two. There's an Ignite, there's a Fortune's End. They're trying to burst him down with the help of the Purifying Flames. Flame Break bumps him back, and they'll get him down. That Ancient Apparition player didn't stand a chance.
Well, nice practicing the name.
I'm just kidding, I've said it enough, Winter. 5-1, though.
Yeah, just as we expected.
Just
the
as
lane,
we expected.
The lane is going to be so difficult for DC.
Yeah. Resolution's still not a good item to his name. He's been able to funnel together at
just,
least 800 gold.
Just think
but,
about
yeah.
what Fnatic did the past 2 minutes. Yeah. They know that the only lane DC is doing well is the Ursa, and they sent a gang squad, and they got him twice. So
and now they've won
all
lanes.
The lanes are down now.
All the lanes are down.
Except for the jungling Beastmaster.
That wasn't the melody I was going for, but nice try, Winter. It looks like Midwan also, he's been having the time of life in the top lane. He's getting close to level 7. He's already got the arcanes. He's making great time on his Timber. Look at this, though. The Wild Moo appears. He's got Primal Roar. He gets it off, but there's already an assault coming in also from Fnatic. They actually have advantage in numbers, coaxing in DC to think they have a situation where they're going to win, but they don't, and it turns into another takedown of Weed. This is turning a disaster for
Digital
Chaos.
They read that timing so well. They noticed Beastmaster pop level 6, so you saw 3-4-3 there. He preemptively TP'd, and DJ was already ready there.
Yeah.
And they were able to get the spin off on the Juggernaut as the Roar hits him. So.
Oh, they've spotted mid one though. Oh. With the boar. He wants Moo. He'll be able to sidestep and hit the Timber Chain. Moo.
That is not good.
Mid one has just gone a bit too deep here.
He's dead.
Might hand over a forgiving kill. Weeha happens to be here, and that's recovery for DC.
Space created.
Space created.
Four heroes to kill one Timber Saw.
Yeah, Fnatic, if you want to be able to hold this dominant early game advantage, you can't be handing over misplays like that.
If you look at the overall net worth, DC are still doing fine. Slug is just a little bit behind off the jump. Beastmaster is pretty farm compared to the Batrider, his counterpart. And Ursa is still doing okay, despite going down twice. It's still in reach for DC.
Oh yeah.
It's not out of hand yet.
Yeah. Fnatic just can't afford to have slip ups like that or get too overzealous, you know, no more of these, you know, feeling like you're the, you know, you have a support staff behind you in these lanes, and don't get too thirsty for kills.
When you win your lanes and you give up kills, you're giving away a lot towards
all that work, all that, the reason you built this draft, you know, all that work you put in could just be casted aside if you do slip it up. Yeah. DC, not a team that is easy to forget.
Those two kills, the kill on the Timber and the kill on the Batrider, are so huge for DC.
Mm-hmm.
And both are big mistakes from Fnatic.
Fnatic, though, I think they still hold a decent XP advantage, so they will be able to get to some level 6s on their supports and be able to light up this mid-game maybe a bit earlier in timing compared to where DC want to be. I mean, Soxa and company still need more time to have Ice Blast online, I imagine. It doesn't feel like the Ricky has been able to do a whole lot either yet. He's been kind of cramped in that bottom lane as a additional support. Bao, top lane, moves back with a roar, catches it on mid one. They follow it up with a stun with an Urshock, and my goodness, they'll take him down. Double takedowns of the Timber.
Well played. This Timber's tempo in the game has been severely hampered by those two deaths, and even though the Ricky is not useful now, like in the laning phase, but later in the game, his smoke is really, really good versus Timber and the Juggernaut. So I can see him being really, really useful later when they are running around, especially with the Beastmaster to catch those heroes.
There's no denying that. He just needs to make sure he has time to get the level so he has a good smoke screen. He has a good, you know, tricks of the trade to work with. But for now, he's camping, hanging around this mid lane. Doesn't want to get too close. There is a sentry planted just behind Mushi here as he continues his grind to farm. Though the Timber and his momentum, as you mentioned, has been halted a bit. They still have the Jug to kind of continue to hit his stride. And I imagine the Batrider is still going to be at least doing good enough to make decent timing for a Blink Dagger.
I think he was I think he was going for a drums first before.
Oh, he's doing drums first.
I think
not huge anti bat though on DC. Do you feel like the drums is necessary to go first? Because I feel like most bats go drums first when it's like, oh, there's an anti, you know, lasso person.
You think about their composition, because they have the ogre. Maybe he was feeling that with the bloodlust, he can actually run at the enemy to deal damage with Firefly plus Napalm. So that might be the top process. And if you look at the overall composition as well, if he can actually run over and kill the AA behind, like with the drum movement speed and the bloodlust giving him much faster movement speed as well, might be very, very useful in the team fights.
Top lane looks like the DC doing a great job on putting these roars to use every time they're off cooldown. They might be coaxing in mid one again here, but this time they actually have Fnatic backup. So the third time you want to try to bait in our Timber Saw, we will have reinforcements ready for you, sir. There will be a trick to the trade. Moo has to actually get the roar off on a DJ. They quickly target the Ogre and they will take him down before he can properly intercept. And that actually forces Fnatic to get the hell out of there. Because of the rotations coming in from DC and their presence, they were able to fend off that gank from Fnatic.
Well, at least they lost the support there. I was like really, really worried about them when they made that dive. Like, it was very, very dangerous there because Midon didn't have too much mana. So if a fight ever breaks out, they might not have enough damage to actually finish heroes off. And but at least they traded a support and Mushi got the tier 1 mid. So it was not too bad for Fnatic overall.
DC though, still hanging around this top lane, but it looks like there's going to be a rotation towards the bottom lane possibly. But Resolution's made his pounce for Ohio here. 343 trying to help out with the Fate's Edict, and it's going to be enough. I'm actually surprised. I guess he couldn't get it on the Slark to stop from attacking, but nonetheless, Batrider will be able to make it away on the back of the TP. Misery, hit with a Fortune's End, hit with an Omni Slash, is going to be able to get off the Trickster trade right there at the end, but the Blade Fury is waiting for him, and Mushi is now on a killing spree on his Jug. Have faith you will be able to carry our team, right?
Yeah. Guys, I trust you guys to do your own thing, and I'm gonna just focus on my own game. That's what he needs to do right now.
Seems to be doing okay with that.
Well, he's choosing to max out his stun though on the Ogre. He has 3 points in stun now, 2 Ignite and 1 Bloodlust.
Is that really that bad? Nope, top lane, mid one, he's gone.
Nah, I'm not necessarily saying it's bad, it's just yesterday and today, all the Ogre games, I see players just prioritize on getting the Bloodlust.
More Bloodlust.
And the Ignite. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant structures are fortified. I mean, I guess if you look at their lineup, what are their lockdowns? Ogre's stun and Batrider's Lust, so are the two only reliable lockdowns.
Oracle's Q? Not enough of a lockdown Radiant's for you?
That's like saying Darkseer's vacuum is lockdown.
Hey, you got some lockdown kills in the mid lane two times straight, so okay. Can't fault it too much.
Right.
Top lane.
I'm sure Ogre spells did more work there, but I'll let it go.
Radiant's bottom we'll see here as they could be potentially sweeping into Fnatic in the top lane. Looks like they'll hold it off. Resolution. Straight to the Shadowblade for his Slark. We've been seeing a lot of Slarks do a juggle between the Echo Saber and the Shadowblade. What comes first, what comes second here. As he goes for a pounce in the mid lane, they try to get a grab on DJ. It's a big target, and if they don't connect, it's going to be that much harder. Ice Blast will come through, but they quickly split. It looks like a connect on the Ogre, but Mushi's going to be fine. Blade Fury. Resolution, though, does the Shadow Dance and will TP out from the trouble. So they avoid the danger. But back to the topic, Slark, Echo Saber, Shadow Blade. Is Resolution making them the right choice going straight for the Shadow Blade?
Well, Shadow Blade will allow him to constantly roll a mid one here.
During the chain. And wow, Wii is just I'm here and I got a Blink Dagger. How you doing?
He just got absolutely destroyed there.
Yeah, that was a crushing for sure. And Fnatic are advancing forward as if they want to respond with something here, knowing that the ulti is down. They're not going to be able to spot out Moon
in
time.
And DC are just doing a really, really good... Ohio actually went down in the meantime. Bottom lane, they caught him against. DC got all these pickoffs, which are just making the game tip back towards their favor. If you look at the net worth, all their three cores are in the top four of the net worth right now. So all those singular pickoffs that Fnatic are giving up, from time to time, are just coming back to bite them. It's really, really bad right now for them.
It looked like we were also just pretty much at that point where this game is back even. So.
Yeah, they got a really good lead from the laning phase, which we expected, but all the pickoffs that they're giving are just like, they're giving back all the hard work that they did in the first 5 to 10 minutes.
They're making the game exciting. They're making the game close.
I'm sure that was part of the plan, Dakota.
Weeha and Misery are in the Roche pit. And it looks like they will secure a swift and easy Aegis for themselves. While Fnatic are busy making a presence here in the top lane.
This is definitely very worrisome. And wow, that's a Midas, a
14-hitting
Midas.
On a support AA. It's like, don't forget my name. Here we go. Roar, out. Moo could be in trouble. Fnatic don't actually want to fall through here. A bit too risky.
They were actually very afraid there, but if the Oracle's ulti came out a little earlier, Juggernaut might have moved forward for the kill, because he needed to remove the stun on the Jug when he was spinning so that they could actually move forward for that kill. But he used it a little too late, so Juggernaut decided not to commit for the kill.
As we can see, this now means that we have a Shadowblade in order for Resolution, but we also get at the same moment Ohio's Blink Dagger on his bat.
They have to make all these initiations count. So now the Batriders game finally begins at minute 15. So they have to use this initiation to sort of get back some control onto the game.
They need to trust that he will do his job.
Yeah. At some point, they need a gem as well against the Shadowblade and the Riki. This is extremely important for the bat this game.
Yep. But it looks like DC.
Yeah, they have the Aegis. They want to move.
Going on the offensive here. Smoked up. Running down this mid lane. Looking for some Fnatic members.
If they get a crucial pickoff here, transition into the mid tower, this would be huge for DC.
Can they do it though? Doesn't look like there's any nearby targets. Fnatic are a bit wary of the situation. They have completely pulled off, and that will allow DC to sweep in, and they're going to go right for the tier 1. Obviously, it's very clear that
they're trying to defend.
I was going to say DC are the enforcers here, but Fnatic are creeping in, seeing if they can grab a sweet little AA pick. He turns around, Ice Blast is going to be a swing and a miss, but nonetheless, they are going to still get the takedown of the Ogre. Weak is going to move on in, tries to get onto 3-4-3. They will be able to get the other support takedown. Mid one also falls. Digital Chaos really shredding things apart now. They're going to go for Mushi here, caught under the smoke screen, and they will slash him apart. Double kill for Resolution. And that is Digital Chaos just battling it out and...
This game is actually falling apart for Fnatic right now. They just gave up too many singular pickoffs after the laning phase, which was a great laning phase for them, but all those pickoffs are just proving to be way too costly for them.
And I don't think it's going to be getting any easier. A lot of Fnatic's...
It's going to be hard though if you look at DC's lineup. Yeah, they have a very weak laning phase, but once they get past that, they go into mid game, they have Beastmaster Hawk, they have Slark, They have Rikki. They have so much map control to do whatever they want with their heroes. And they have Ursa and Slark running around setting up kills with the Beastmaster. And they have a global Ice Blast. So all those kills are extremely easy for them. So this is getting towards the phase where it's very difficult for Fnatic to move out on the map.
And in traditional Beastmaster kind of games, if you're handing over huge fights to DC, they have great pushing power too. So they'll take objectives.
They're basically going to get controlled and contained right now in their side of the map. They're not going to be able to move out safely unless they group up as five.
Uh-oh, Bushi, who is trying to farm here in the bottom lane.
Yeah, he's dead.
So he'll get between three. Yeah, they have a roar and everything waiting for him. Mid-1 tries to come in. Does get off some good damage, but unless he finds a way out, he's thirsty here. He gets the false promise, and they have enough bursting power to at least take the Aegis down. But now they have to run back, and it was a
casual
hit, but
okay, Tree Fall Tree's dead.
Weeha's already there on the case, and they're going to get that takedown as well. 15-9, DC have pulled way out and ahead now as we make our way through the mid game. So Fnatic, strong start with a strong laning draft, but pick off after pick off, eventually DC just kind of take whatever freebies come their way, and they don't hand up anything else to Fnatic, but
the support Fnatic is running down your car.
Over. Yeah, Fnatic though, hand over fist, giving DC so much now, and DC are just going to happily take it and run away with it. They get their Roche, they get their assertive lead, and now they're just taking tier 2s.
The problem is like their heroes are just mostly focused on single targets, so once they gave up so much kills, so many kills towards DC, and DC having the composition of a better teamfight with the vision, the ice blast, the smoke screen from the Rikki. So teamfights have been very, very difficult for Fnatic after the last 5 minutes or so where all the exchanges were all DC favored. They have to somehow get a lot of sentries. I don't think they can afford a gem now, so they need all those sentries to be able to slowly remove the vision, maybe catch a Rikki a few times, or even a Slark if possible, and slowly claw their way back into the game.
Yeah, I hope Midwan with his
another
new Bloodstone is involved in everything, but yeah, you're seeing both supports on DC now with the Midas. They've already prepared for the rest of the game and beyond.
Can they get this kill, Dakota? This is really important.
It's a Slark. He is very slippery and very fast, and he is gone. So there's your answer, winner. They can't get him.
This is getting extremely, extremely infuriating for Fnatic. They are losing map control. They can't get pickoffs. They have to group up and huddle together because they are very worried about the Slark catching out lone heroes with the Ice Blast.
And for Fnatic, for DC, you just get one big pick off here and you take another tower and you begin your siege and assault into the base.
If they get another pick off, the game might just be over. So it's... can they find the Oracle? Yes, they can.
Yes, they can. They found him. He's right there. Winner. False Promise himself. In desperation mode to save, tries to heal his way through it, but he ate enough pot shots there. And even Misery gets in one little jab. But that does mean that Misery's going to be a bit out of position, and they pull him right back up into the base, and they'll take care of it. He probably would have been dead without Misery jabbing in those extra shots, but
just making sure
that he's just trying to secure a kill, but unfortunately that does mean that he loses his own life. Just a trade back and forth, but as you can see, it's only a minor little dent in the DC graph, where they are already way up and ahead.
Yep, for Fnatic, they're just happy that they didn't lose more, you know? Like, that looked like it could have been a really bad fight.
It was bad. It could have been worse, though, guys. We're fine.
It could have been worse, you know?
It could have been worse, but it wasn't, so we get to fight on for, you know?
Live to fight another day, Dakota.
And hope that that one will be a bit more promising.
So, they're close. They're halfway to the 4-star on bat. I still think it's very important for them to get the gem. Like, whatever items they're getting in the next 5 minutes, it's not going to change the game as much as a gem will change the game.
Yeah. But I have okay high ground defense too. The power of the bat, you have the vision of a gem.
It's
maybe they
decent.
Get cheeky pickoff from the high ground.
Plus the Firefly, they should be able to hold on for some time, but not for long if they get picked off, so they have to be very careful.
Yeah, the problem is that DC also have pretty good siege. I mean, they have
Necrobook.
The Beastmaster Vision, Necrobook, so...
Courier gonna run by.
Uh-oh. Yeah, a little too far away. Resolution's not gonna bother. And now they are the ones that I like to say are the sharks in the water swimming around Fnatic's base, while Fnatic just try to find any way to creep out on any sort of adventure, push some side lanes, get some tier 2s if possible, and just get some farm. But the second he makes his presence in the bottom lane, they have to quickly pull out. The rest of Fnatic all trying to make an escape here. The one man left behind is mid one, though. He does go for the TP. Not gonna make it.
Man, mid one is just getting picked off way too much. Like, just way too much this game.
He had like one like super high impact Timbersaw game. I want to say it was here in Starlight, or it might have been Summit, but ever since then, I haven't seen a whole lot of crazy Timbersaw shenanigans. I don't know if that's, you know,
maybe
on his end, or
maybe this was one of the reasons why they wanted to switch their system, because they understand that Midon can sometimes be way too aggressive, and they want to avoid that. I don't know, man, this game is really, really bad ever since that he, you know, the first kill that he gave up at top, he dove the tower, and he didn't get the kill, mm-hmm. and then it all started to fall, like, into a bad phase for him after that.
Yeah, he's had the repercussions ever since then. It's Fnatic kind of stuck in their closet.
Ooh,
oh, they
Ricky.
Move out. Oh, they pop the dust. They spotted out Misery. He delays it quite a bit though, going into tricks to trade, but certainly they will be able to bring down the Ricky, who's just kind of tanks the movement out for Fnatic. Not the worst thing in the world for DC.
That's probably the best case, a second best case scenario for them, losing the Ricky. The yeah. best case would be not losing anyone, obviously, but... if DC can secure the next Roshan, then the game would be like, it's already very difficult for Fnatic, but if they get the next Roshan, then it would be really, really hard for them to come back.
Is it bad enough where Fnatic need to formulate a game plan on deterring DC away from the Roshan or stealing it themselves? I don't even know if they have the
map
tools
control.
To do so.
It comes back to map control. They need to have a good vision, good initiation.
Mm-hmm.
If they don't have vision, it's very difficult for Bad to move in, because as we spoke, there's a Beastmaster Hawk, there's Ricky running around, there's so many things that can give DC vision. But for Fnatic, none of their heroes can help the Bad with his initiation apart from having good wards.
Yeah.
I guess with the Bloodlust, you can say that giving him more move speed helps, but he still needs a good amount of vision, which he doesn't have right now.
Alright, well, DC know that the Roche could be up in the near future. I think we saw the timer. It's a long one, so for the sake of Fnatic, they do get to stay in the game a little bit longer to try to farm up a way in contesting, or at least breaking the momentum that DC have already built for themselves. But DC are going to obviously be first in line to move in and get this Roche and further secure a way to easily be able to siege in the base.
Here comes the initiation.
Line.
Are they going to make a move here?
Oh,
yes, they are.
The move's already been made. It looks like it's there for DJ, while Ohio does get the grab on Moo. A big grab at that. Can they burst down this Beastmaster in time? They try to go for it, committing in with everything they got. They are going to be able to drop him. Goes Misery. Steps in, gets off the tricks of the trade. Going to be able to get the finish onto the Oracle. Makes it a 2-for-1 trade. Fnatic, they need to really make it back in the base and alive if they want to make this worth it, but they're not. Mid 1 does go down. You know, it's a great move outside the base for Fnatic, taking down their Prime Initiator and Vision Holder in Mu, but they lose 3 doing so.
And
that means that's going to be an easy road for DC.
And just DC are just all over Fnatic right now in total control of this game after the disastrous laning phase. And Fnatic can all but hope right now that their base defense works with the Batrider and Timber. They have totally surrendered full control of the map towards DC. It's not much they can do right now, but try and just defend their high ground.
We'll see. It'd have to be a Hail Mary of a defense right now to ward off DC.
Oh yeah, that's Aghanim's on
AA,
the Ursa.
Right?
No, it's Aghanim's on the Ursa.
Oh, it's Ursa's AA.
Yeah.
Or
so
Ursa's Axe.
There's
nice.
No way they can lock him down right now.
Oof. Yeah, any potential stun, he could just simply click his R button to get out from any sort of trouble. I mean, they were having a hard enough time as it is to now take down the Ursa. But now, oof, Mushi is able to kind of put together his Manta style.
I guess they can just look for a push fairly soon. Every important item has been already there for DC. So we'll just see whether they feel like they're ready to push. Push out all the lanes and just try to siege down the mid lane.
And for DC, if they try to make their approach here, I mean, you have Beastmaster to help with the vision, but are you putting together a game plan where you just kind of lure out your Aegis candidate in the front until Fnatic are forced to fight, or are you, you know, thinking of something else and the best way to get inside?
I mean, the best way would probably be getting the jump yourself, so you kill someone immediately, the Oracle, which is target, because
yeah.
you can save everyone else. So you want to kill the Oracle first, and then you kill him, and then you siege. That would be the best case scenario. The other option would be to just have, obviously, the, like you suggested, the guy with the Aegis sieging the tower,
yeah,
and just wait for Fnatic to make a move.
They're quickly taking out any sort of vision. All sentries on the outskirts here.
Oh, here comes Riha.
Oh, they gotta be careful. Fnatic will look at the door, and they're gonna get spotted, and DJ could get bursted here. He will be taken down. He's gonna be out of the fight. No buyback for him. Ice Blast does fly through. It connects with Mushi. Already has the False Promise. Just runs back to base, but no, not gonna be able to make it. The AA ult is just a bit too much, and too much firepower under that False Promise means that Mushi is gonna be taken down. He's out for 54 seconds, no buyback for him, and it looks like this could be the beginning of the end as DC approach themselves into the base.
And, seems like GG here.
Mid one, you know, he'll do his last ditch effort to be the mech to try to fight his way out from this one, but it ain't gonna be happening. Resolution steps out. Our Resolution steps in where Weeha had to step out, and we'll finish up the job here, cleaning out not one, but two, and secures a double kill for himself. But back to what's important, they're going to get these racks down in the bottom lane. And with pretty much most of Fnatic waiting in the sidelines watching, I imagine that they're beginning to game plan a very hype game number three.
Right now, in most situations, the team is deciding, why did we lose this game? Was it the draft? Was it the execution? Or was it like an unlucky circumstances and an unlucky rune? You know? Those are the moments where you talk about it, and then you get ready for your next game.
And where do you think Fnatic's pointing the finger? I'm not saying they're a team to point the finger, of course,
yeah,
but,
I mean,
you know, where do you think that, what, we talked about it a couple of times, but if you had to now see the game in the grand spectrum, is it just Fnatic? I don't think getting too comfortable. They had the advantage in the laning phase, but just at times, I guess,
the pickoffs,
like
they got a bit
overzealous on going for kills and handing over opportunities for DC to really be on the fight back here. More or less, a lot of the same bloodshed we're seeing here inside the Fnatic base. Is DC really running rampant here? They've been able to take down the mid set of racks, and they're going to be going for the final set here at the top lane with the Necrobook already out and Mu going to town right now. It's all but certain that Digital Chaos have secured this game too. Ohio trying to get the last little chuckle as he lassos back Wii, but it's going to be them who are laughing at the end as they're going to slash through both of them. But sure enough, DC will be able to secure game number two, and we'll be going into a three-game series for our first series of day three coverage. That's game.
Well, if I were to point a finger, I think Timber would be the one that I'm pointing my finger at this game. Both the Timber and the Batrider, the kills that they gave up in the laning phase after all the hard work that the Ogre and Oracle did was just unforgiving. They could not afford to make those mistakes and give up so much towards DC.
And as we can see, DC, relief. You know, you're going into game number two, you're already down game one, and you're looking at a draft where you don't have too many options to really be able to succeed in the laning stage, but you put that aside, you battle your way out, and you find those opportunities, those slip-ups that Fnatic are willing to hand over, and next thing you know, you move past the highlighting moment for Fnatic and you hit your own stride.
I mean, this game is also a very good example of why Beastmaster is just such a good hero. Like, he did so much for his team, like despite putting his team in a very difficult spot by jungling at the start of the game. But
I'm very anxious to hear what the rest of our panel members have to say about this game.
Are you?
I am. I'm super, super excited to do that and go to the bathroom. So what we're going to do now is we're going to cut to a break. When we come back, we'll break down game number two and get hyped up and ready for game three of Digital Chaos versus Fnatic.